Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics. This can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck. Wichita Dwight D. Eisenhower National is a medium to large-sized multi-use metropolitan airport located on the western edge of the city of Wichita, Kansas. The airport serves air carrier, air taxi, cargo, corporate, and general aviation, as well as military traffic. The city of Wichita has been called the heart of general aviation in the United States. It is home to several major general and corporate aircraft manufacturing facilities. Many of these facilities are located at company-specific airports, such as the Cessna and Beech Airfields located to the east, while others are located on the Wichita Airport. McConnell Air Force Base is located approximately 7 miles southeast of Wichita and has a similar runway configuration. It has been mistaken for Wichita, and pilots making their first visit are cautioned to be mindful of this when approaching the area. The runway configuration consists of parallel runways 1 and 19er left and right. Runway 1 left, 19er right is intersected by runway 1432. As with any airport with parallel runways and staggered thresholds, pilots must exercise extra vigilance to ensure they operate on the appropriate surface. There are several different factors that may lead pilots to attempt to land on the wrong runway. The complex system of taxiways provides access to air carrier, cargo, and transient general aviation facilities, primarily located between the parallel runways. Specific aircraft manufacturing facilities are located outside the parallel taxiways on the east and west sides of the airport. There are several flight schools and technical institutes located on the airport as well. This mix of pilot experience and aircraft capability make Wichita a challenging airport for pilots and controllers. Hotspot 1 is located at the intersection of taxiways Kilo and Bravo in close proximity to runway 1432. Pilots who miss the turn from Bravo to Kilo will find themselves very quickly on runway 1432. Close attention to taxi instructions, including route, turns, and hold short instructions, is imperative before beginning to taxi. If at any time pilots feel unsure of their assigned route or clearance, they should hold short and ask the tower. An extra transmission or two is far better than a potentially catastrophic mistake. Hotspot 2 concerns aircraft landing or departing runway 19er right, 1 left, and utilizing taxiway Delta. Aircraft transiting the parallel taxiway Delta are reminded that this route crosses runway 1432. And remember, clearance is required to cross any runway on your taxi route. Not mentioned as a hotspot, but an area of concern for corporate and general aviation aircraft departing the transient parking area, is the misidentification of taxiways Alpha and November. Pilots have not recognized they were crossing Alpha, continued across November thinking it was Alpha, and ended up on runway 1 right, 19er left. The consequences are obvious. Continuous scanning outside the aircraft for markings and signage, as well as deferring heads down time while taxiing, will go a long way in avoiding this error. Wichita is in the beginning stages of a lengthy airport construction project that will go a long way in mitigating, if not eliminating, these issues. However, until the project is completed, pilots need to exercise heightened awareness when operating in these areas and, of course, check NOTAMs. As mentioned earlier, there are several different sized airports in the general vicinity of Wichita. The Class Charlie Inner Ring provides protection for Wichita, but the majority of these airports are located beneath the outer ring. The base of that ring begins at 2,700 and extends up to 5,300 MSL. There have been several instances of aircraft making approaches to and actually landing at the wrong satellite airport. When planning a trip to Wichita, pilots should make themselves thoroughly familiar with the different airports and airspace requirements. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at Wichita will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the air traffic control tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Wichita Dwight D. Eisenhower National Airport. It's always better to know before you go.